приглашается Борисенко Александр Николаевич.
Rebel soldiers listen out for their names, a roll call of men honored for their service in battle. Today in Donetsk, it's a public holiday, Defender of the Fatherland Day, borrowed from Russia. Light entertainment for the troops, even a wedding ceremony. I ask one woman, beaming in the winter sunshine, why she has a flag of Stalin. Stalin was also fighting against fascism, and he won, she says. We also want to have a victory like he did. Stalin also brought catastrophic hunger to eastern Ukraine. But that's forgotten now in a city where Russia can do no wrong.
This is all about meeting the people's needs, their most basic needs, food, putting on a show for them. Also a chance for the rebels to really drive home their agenda.
Which seems to have a very clear message.
You see, all people here, they think that Ukraine is between Russia and USA.
In amongst the hugs and good cheer, there's also a sense this war is not done.
There is no way back. We will fight to the last. We must finish what we started.
A little girl, mini rebel in the making, recites the poetry her grandma taught her, an anthem to Novorossiya. I ask God for the rebels' victory, she says. They will kick out the fascist filth. How many people must suffer? How many children? How many old people? She speaks the rebels' language, wants to fight on their side when she's old enough to carry a real gun. Diana-Magnay, CNN, Donetsk.